which is permitted, I believe, according, if permitted by a special permit. We have some steps we still have to go through with the utility as well. We've done a preliminary investigation. We're close to the Hurley substation here, which benefits the interconnection of the system. But there's still some engineering work that has to be done, but we want to make sure that we can get a permit to proceed first.
And the remaining 4 acres on the site, does that allow for future expansion? Is that what that's for? Or?
I think we've pretty much occupied, we're proposing to occupy the area that would be suitable for this kind of a use. I have some site plan drawings here, I'm not sure I have enough to pass a couple around. To the west, north, it's heavily treed, and that's where the creek is. To the east is a farmer's field. To the south, if you go a little bit further, there's the New York State Thruway. So it's essentially not visible from any residential zone. It's a very low-profile system. The bottom left-hand drawing there shows the maximum height of the rack is about 7 feet 8 inches tall. There are, of course, being solar, there's no moving parts, there's no emissions, there's no pollution. Construction involves pressing steel posts with a hydraulic machine into the ground, and then there will also be some pressing of fence posts to encircle the perimeter, and then some temporary trench excavation for buried electrical lines. It's very minimal disturbance with this type of construction. Most of it is electrical and mechanical assembly work that occurs above ground. Some pictures of the site here that we can share just to give you an idea of what it looks like now.
So there will not be any lighting on this, correct?
No, there's no lighting, with the exception of switchable service lights in case some service has to continue after dark or something.
And how frequently do these things have to be serviced by folks?
Relatively rarely. The system will have internet monitoring, so we will be able to monitor the solar system and all parts of it to know that it's working. There'll be some security cameras just to keep an eye on it. The service, the equipment is very reliable. The solar panels themselves have a 25-year warranty from the manufacturer. The inverters will have a 25-year warranty. Other than that, it's wiring, switchgear.
Do
Good, good. So when we talk about the term to coincide, this is your recommendation to coincide with the lease of the property from St. Clair's. How long is the lease? 25 years? So at this time, I'll make a motion that we approve item number 8 for a period of 3 years with board policy 6 to be adhered to. That is a motion. Do I have a second? Second by William Tubby. All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Thank you.
Happy to see that the assessor updated to show that there were five apartments or having been were placed on the proximity of the parking back in the 80s. They relied on a lot on North Union Street, which is no longer under the same ownership. Also, there's a question of fire access. The planning department had asked whether we could do a easement, sadly, because the properties are in the same ownership. An easement would immediately merge with the underlying ownership of 82 West Union in this case. So an easement will help us. What I would propose in place of that is that one of your conditions be that 82 West Union remain in the same ownership as 101 Beale Street, because it does the back fire egress would need to physically cross that property.
A lot line revision potentially to make what is currently marked on the map as an easement part of where I want to be able to make an issue.
Okay, you can hear my
potentially you can grant the property that the easement is currently on to 101 Beale Street.
You're talking about merging the parcels?
Or doing a lot line revision to take that section of the property?
I'm not sure that would fit the setback requirements. I mean, I don't have a survey.
Well, in any event, the easement that is currently on the books is, or rather, the requirement for the easement has not been met. So in order for the building department to authorize this to go forward, that can, that issue has to be resolved. How you resolve it is something between you and the building department, but the permit shouldn't be granted from the planning board until that issue is finally resolved, because at this point there's no second exit from the apartments.
Well, my proposal would be to keep both parcels in common ownership, allowing that access. And that would be...
That would then be essentially a lot line deletion.
Yeah.
There has to be some kind of a legal, because that's the issue that,
So are you asking me to transfer one of the properties to another entity for the purpose of creating an easement? Am I following you guys?
Well, I think what's being asked is for resolution of this issue before the permit is granted. How do you resolve it is something that you have to, determine.
Well, I would argue that the idea of those parcels being in common ownership and that it remain in common ownership for the special permit, that it become a condition of the special permit, would also do that sufficiently.
I understand where you're coming from. However, that was, we ran across this with the original special permit, which was issued saying that the parking that was originally called West Union Street to be affiliated with this lot, they were sold separately. So that lot was sold off. So now the city's in a position where there is no longer the off-street parking. There had been when the original permit was issued.
Right, and there's now a provision in the code for a waiver,
and
there is new public parking that didn't exist in 86.
So what I'm getting at is that there's nothing technically to say that the property can now be sold off separately. And then this aspect is no longer.
It would not.
We need a more permanent resolution to this issue than the one you're proposing.
All right. Then what would we be discussing, and with whom should we be discussing it? This is the next question. We'd be discussing a fire access issue with whom? This board or with the building department?
Ways, I mean, you would have to do actually a lot line deletion by both parcels under one property. stay as such. Or you can look for a subdivision to subdivide off of that piece and create a formal easement and becomes.
An easement wouldn't require a lot line revision. We would just, and that would just have to be surveyed out and described.
It would be surveyed out, we have to be, the document have to be recorded.
Both deeds would have to have language in it for, to allow access, right, the easement?
Correct.
Right, you would give notice in the one and then you would provide the right crossing in the other. All right, I'm looking to about be discussing it. The building department with your office, Sue, who are we?
All of the above, the adequate solution is agreed upon.
Okay. All right.
It probably would be the, what's the best course of action that your client would want to, what's, you know, what would be the most least painful, I think, right, looking at that?
My suspicion will be a transfer to a new entity and as an easement, but we'll discuss that with both you, the building department, and anyone else. All right.
Still have to address the parking, the question of parking.
Right.
Given that the previous, the parking was on the site that you are.
Right, and I've submitted a measurement showing that we're 243 feet away from the nearest public parking.
And in this parcel, we're talking about the, some of the West Union, that's the other side we're talking about?
EB2 West Union.
That's a vacant parcel, right? Is that, or is that?
I believe there's a building on EB2 West Union.
There is?
Okay.
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 I didn't know if it was a vacant parcel we were talking about or it's a residential structure.
It already has and has had for, oh my gosh, at least 120 years.
All right. So could we take any action tonight? Are we going to have some, what do we do with this? First time we've ever had something like this come across the side of the internet. You know,
just our luck.
If it was just a parking issue, or if there was a more permanent solution with regard to the easement, we wouldn't have a problem with the condition of approval.
Yeah.
Both issues outstanding, and having a firm proposal to resolve the easement issue, I wouldn't have a problem with any kind of condition of approval.
Do you have somebody already interested in buying it now, or are you in?
Yes, we do. So, we are hoping to get this set up as quickly as possible.
Well, our advice is to get these issues resolved before we take action.
Is there going to be an August meeting?
No, we're moving into September. We typically have, well, in August there's no meeting, we're usually.
Is there a way to approve any portion of this? Because having this spill over to September is going to be, it's trouble for us. Can it be conditioned on approval by the building department, by the planning department, by another entity?
Dan, we're reiterating what you said. Your recommendation is not to have any condition based on the, until we get this resolved.
Not a firm, you know, proposal and a permanent resolution to the easement issue. I'm not comfortable with any kind of action. The original plans for the building indicated that this easement was going to be granted decades ago. The building has functioned without the easement being granted, and technically without, you know, emergency access. So I'm not comfortable with continuing that situation and just entrusting that it's going to be taken care of after.
I understand the gravity of your situation here with this. I do, but I don't. Our advice is to let the least let this issue be taken care of first before we take any further action on it. I know you're under the gun.
Okay.
Right? I believe I understand what you're going through here, and I wish there was something else we could do at this point, but we have to get that aspect resolved first.
All right.
All right.
Do you need any other documentation on other than what's been presented on other issues?
No. The only thing we would need is we're going to have to sit down and figure out a solution to the easement or how to resolve the emergency access.
All right. Thank you.
All right, Mark.
Okay.
Thanks.
All right, sir. So at this time, I'll make a motion that we table item number 9. Do I have a second? Second by Chuck Palacco. All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
Thanks.
All right. Take care, gentlemen.
Good night.
Set aside even the cultural creative rewards that it offers, Research has shown in the United States alone in 1 year, $704.2 billion in the U.S. economy. Here in Ulster County, a 2014 study found that the total economic impact of Ulster County's arts and culture in a single year, $23.5 million. Artistic events drew 1.1 million day visitors and over 380,000 overnight visitors. People attending cultural events inject money into the local economy. And in that same study, in that same year in Ulster County, people attending events injected $161 million into the Ulster County economy. And just to conclude, having a new state-of-the-art theater in Kingston would benefit certainly our local businesses, but it would play an important role in our identity as a community. Having the cultural center certainly would allow us to come together and celebrate Irish culture, literature, dance, music, but having the theater itself will give us a public space to come together as a community to tell and experience the stories that are meaningful and important to all of us. Theater teaches us about who we are. It reminds us what it means to be human. And in this increasingly tech-driven and highly politicized age, theater keeps us grounded and connected to one another. It comforts and challenges us, and theater is how a community reflects itself. The Irish Cultural Center and its theater will reflect the values, the identity, and the amazing culture of the city of Kingston and our community. I really encourage you to throw your full support behind the ICC, and I thank you very much for this opportunity.
Thank you, Ms. Montchain. Owen Harvey.
Thank you for that. And thank you, Board. Just take it out. Is this okay? I'm Owen Harvey. I live at 26 of Beale Street. I just wanted to reiterate several points, I guess, that were delivered to this board from Green Plan Inc. and Fitzpatrick Engineering. One, the planning board needs to issue a positive declaration on SEAKER. As demonstrated in the supporting letters from Green Plan and Fitzpatrick Engineering, there is no basis in fact for the City of Kingston Planning Board to issue a negative declaration for the Irish Cultural Center Hudson Valley. The application provided by the ICCHV does not contain proper safety analysis, nor does the application provide a thorough assessment of concurrent area venues that potentially would degrade operational efficiency and safety. There is no properly conducted parking study provided. There was no traffic impact study conducted. There continues to be unresolved potential harm to neighboring residential land uses. Point two, unenclosed uses, radio stations, and drinking establishments are not permitted by right in the Broadway West Strand area where the applicant has claimed frontage. Unenclosed uses are not permitted by right for buildings with direct frontage in the Broadway West Strand area. Uses not fully enclosed in a structure are subject to the issuance of a special permit by the planning board. The issuance of a special permit is only permitted for the areas of the district outside the Broadway West Strand area as defined in the zoning code. As such, the ICCHV's plans for an unenclosed use of its roof is not permitted by right and would require a variance from the ZBA. The applicant is proposing operating a radio station out of their proposed building. A radio station is not a use permitted by right for buildings with direct frontage in the Broadway West Strand area. Such use is only permitted by special permit in M1 light manufacturing districts. As such, the ICCHV would require a variance from the ZBA to operate a radio station from their site. A drinking establishment is only permitted in parts of the IT district outside the Broadway West Strand area by special permit. Restaurants are permitted in the Broadway West Strand area, but they are defined as being permitted to only serve beverages. Only drinking establishments are defined as being permitted to serve alcoholic beverages. Existing structures in the Broadway West demonstrate that use was there prior. The applicant is putting forth a new build where there was no prior use as a drinking establishment. Bullet 3. Applicant request for a parking waiver does not meet the requirements as outlined in the city's zoning codes. In code 40519 RT Rondout District, it is recognized that the nature of existing buildings, lot layout, topography, and other physical features in the district are such that adherence to rigid regulations may prove difficult. Therefore, procedures to permit appropriate flexibility of development have been established.
30 seconds left.
Sorry. The applicant has failed to demonstrate that their inability to meet the guidelines for parking requirements is due to the limits of an existing structure, lot layout, topography, or other physical feature. Rather, they have only demonstrated that their inability to meet this mandate is self-created due to the size and scale of their proposed project. There's another bullet in my letter, which I'll include to you, but I also wanted to include a map of the RT district because I go over where the West Strand and Broadway district area is, and also the areas of Abeel Street that are zoned for the type of uses that Broadway West Strand area warrants if you have frontage there. What you'll notice though is that Abeel Street between Broadway and Wirtz is not in that area, and that is where not only my home, but Deanna Bowne's home is located, which is zoned for residential use only, according to the zoning codes. So please,
would you get that for us?
I have a copy for everyone.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Harvey. Ms. Thatcher, are you still in the audience? Do you want to provide a copy of your comments to us, or do you want to email that to us?
I can have the email.
Okay.
Kate Cook.
Good evening, Kate Cook, 283 Thomas Street. I am also a member of Ladies Ancient Order of Hibernians. I'd like to defer my time to Katie Dwyer, if that's okay. Thank you.
Rob Warrenstein.
Also, Tony Myers was feeling like she ceded her time to me and asked me to speak for her.
Who are you speaking
for? Joanne Myers, she's on your list. Okay. She wasn't feeling well. She left and she ceded her time to me. Okay, guys, so let's talk about the white elephant in the room as far as I'm concerned. Parking. This has created an incredibly divisive line between people who were formerly friends. I have a business in Ward 8. Many of the people here are from Ward 8. I don't know how many people speaking for the OICC are from Ward 8. I know there's one couple that owns a business there. But honestly, this affects us in Ward 8, particularly on Abeel Street. People can come from Woodstock or any place else and speak to the benefits. And I am sure there will be some benefits. But right now, in the city of Kingston, we are speaking to you as your constituents from the ward where this project is proposed. The other thing I'd like to say, talking about feelings first and facts second, we all know, and it would be a lie to deny the fact that many of you have been my customers and could not even park to come to dinner 2 years ago, 3 years ago, 4 years ago. Some of you would even use my tenant's lot behind the restaurant that we own for my tenants with my permission. Because you didn't want to have to walk in the rain or the snow or with the children. There are people here, they were in for dinner with other family members who didn't even want to use the shuttle to go to the Bob Dylan show. They left their car in around that area and walked because the shuttles just don't do the job well enough. The parking situation is one that I do feel It is not caused by the YCC. The lack of parking and the lack of planning for enlargement is a city problem. And I would love to see the city address this prior to building a Field of Dreams and hope that the parking will come. I think this is a little backwards. I think help is needed for many, many people. As I sat there tonight, there were three buildings on Appeal Street alone that are coming in. One is a commercial space that will be using the big 10 spaces on Appeal Street, which I was told was a lot that was built for the Armadillo. I'm making a joke. Somebody said that to me tonight. Municipal lot, 10 spaces, Appeal Street, Rock Hall. So, yes, of course my customers use it. The New Progressive Baptist Church uses it. 115 Appeal Street, which came up before you tonight, uses it. I did not hear the full wording of 101 Appeal Street, but from what it sounded like to me, they would be using it too. There are now three bed and breakfasts. Joe Marchetti, who hasn't seen any improvement in the area in 30 years, I take offense at that, has a bed and breakfast, plus his where he lives. They're using the lot also because he doesn't have parking for his bed and breakfast. The building that he sold to Jeff Amarillo now has a bed and breakfast. They don't have a parking lot for their bed and breakfast. So there's 10 spots on the Field Street. Let's face it, they're overused. We are desperate for parking. I speak to you today simply because I could lose my business. And I know people really, you know, I don't blame them for not caring. They had their own agenda. But for me, after over 30 years in this area, it would be a shame to see the Armadillo no longer be here. And I am very seriously speaking the truth. We have another lovely inn, the Forsyth Inn, which also, they have their own parking, but what if somebody wants to visit them? They'll need a little spot or two. This is not to speak poorly about anyone's efforts to do theater or anything they care to do. We have UPAC, by the way, which is a great theater. There used to be drinking at the Bridgewater Cafe, but when Mike Piazza bought that building, he was told by the city there will never be another drinking establishment there because it's residentially zoned. He said no to Mike Piazza. What are you going to say? Yes to someone else? But again, that's a city issue. I have approached many people in the city. I've even asked the mayor. There is a big vacant lot across the street where the Hotel Noah was. The city and the people that own that now have all these new properties uptown, and we have a great big hole in the ground. I even went to Bob Carey and asked if he'd go to the mayor with me, but he expressed to me that he was too busy.
We have 30 seconds.
Okay. I would like to see that Hotel Noah turned into a parking lot. It would solve everyone's problems. Fill it in, make parking. It is a hole in the ground, and nobody will be divided over this issue anymore. This is a city problem that I would like to see solved, and you're going to really need to consider doing a positive CEQA in order to get help to settle the parking issues. I thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Borenstein. To solve the parking problem. It is not the function of a business owner. business owner comes in and takes great risk, opens a restaurant, opens a B&B, opens a hotel, and hopes that people will come. Now, my office originally was on 45 North Front Street, uptown Kingston. And in the time I was up there, I would say 30 years, between Dyson's and the diner, up the street, make a right on Wall Street, you have 16 restaurants. None of them have parking. And now we're opening boutique hotels. One diagonally across from my new office on 60 Pearl Street, I moved from North Front Street because of the parking problem. As we all know, if you're honest, when you have businesses, you have deliveries. So you try and get through North Front Street. More and more people, every planning board meeting I come to, and I'm against nobody's business. This city has to decide whether it wants to put its head in the ground and stop growing. I think we all know IBM isn't coming back. We have entrepreneurs coming up, buying the Woolworth building, buying the Toner building, making a boutique hotel out of it. They bought what they call the Kremlin on Fair Street, another boutique hotel. I'm not against them, absolutely not against them. We both all know sitting here, they have no parking. The Maritime Center has no parking. If you look at the size of their facility, they've grown from 1 to 3 buildings. No parking. And a lot of people may not know, but right across from the Maritime Boat Building, which used to be Rosita's, there's plans to put up on that lawn. Somebody just bought those buildings. They want to put up a two-story with retail downstairs and apartments up. Where are those people going to be parking? So I'm not against parking. But the Irish Cultural Center has every right to be built on the property where it is. That is where the Irish was. That was called Little Dublin. Look in your history books for the new people that have moved here. That is where the Irish did the brickyards, the bluestones, that dug the canal. That is where the Irish Cultural Center belongs. Parking is a straw man. I agree with Merle. The city is very late to address it. On North Front Street, I talked to the previous mayor about the parking lots on North Front Street, and they were in horrible shape. And I said, if you're going to rebuild them after the other one collapsed, why don't you walk 4 stories, 5 stories, build a real parking garage? Instead, the city spent millions, redid it beautifully, it looks great, but how many parking spaces did they add? They're keeping their head in the sand. This city's going to die without municipal parking. We want businesses, we want theaters. UPAC has no parking, it sits on Broadway. Except for the lot across from Guido's and Lindley, which is a municipal lot, where would you park without it? We need municipal parking. We can't stop growing the city. We can't keep discouraging entrepreneurs to come in here and expand the tourist base. Tourism is going to be our only business. We better wake up to that fact. Thank you.
There's city that represented, except in my myth that the Hibernians and the Irish Cultural Center built together, but you know, there's been so much connotation about, oh, 3 years and drunken Irishmen, and with all the coolies that we've had, how many arrests have we had? How much trouble have we had with the St. Patrick's Day parades? It's, we've always supported the city has always supported us. We have a right to build, and when we do build, we'll work together with the Armadillo, with the neighbors, with whomever. That's what Kingston's all about. You know, there's not much that can be said tonight that hasn't been said before, but it's about culture, it's about community. There's two elephants in the room. One is parking, we all know that. The other one is blindness, you know, let's open our eyes and work together and build something beautiful. Thank you.
My name is Katie Dwyer. My address is 95 Madison Avenue, Kingston. I'm also a business owner and an employer in the city of Kingston, and I'm here to express my support of the building of the Irish Cultural Center Hudson Valley at 32 Abele Street. I'd like to address three issues that are used as arguments against the project: location, size, and parking. As for the location, I keep hearing right project, wrong location. This is absolutely the right location, and here's why. The history. The Rondack area was once known as New Dublin because of the mostly Irish D&H canal dock workers that grew up on that hillside. A cultural center should be built in an area that possesses the history which that cultural center seeks to preserve. The events. The Ulster County's largest Irish events of the year are held on the Kingston waterfront. The Shamrock Run and St. Patrick's Day Parade both culminate at Broadway and West Strand, and the Hooli on the Hudson exclusively takes place there. The location of these Irish events makes 32 Abele the right location for the Irish Cultural Center. The neighborhood. This is not an exclusively residential area of the RT district. In the two blocks of Abele between Broadway and Home Street are a florist, a salon, a restaurant, an active garage, two B&Bs, an art gallery, and not long ago, a bar and restaurant that before that was a nightclub. There are numerous businesses being operated out of homes on Abele, plans for commercial space in 115 Abele, and 101 Abele is for sale as a commercial use building. Adding the ICC at 32 Abele will help the flow from Broadway up Abele, encouraging foot traffic to places like the Armadillo. The ICC is a prime example of an infill project. The size. The proposed ICC building is only a two-story building with what is known as a walkout or daylight basement. Because the building is being constructed on a slope, the height at grade from the first floor of the roofline conforms to and is under the code requirement at 34 feet 10 inches, not the 49 feet that keeps being reported. Because of the elevation difference between the ICC property and the adjoining properties, the ICC building will visually be shorter than the residence at 26 Abele next door. The parking. Not a single other business along the Rondout area of Broadway, West Strand, or Abele provides on-site parking for their customers. The ICC will provide some on-site parking, plus even more parking in their additional lot, pending Common Council's approval of parking on accessory lots citywide, a decision which will be a benefit for so many other businesses. This is an old code which has no discernible modern purpose. In fact, the apartments at 50 Abele are already using a lot across the street as parking for their residents. Additionally, consideration is being given for the owners of two boutique hotels in Uptown Kingston to allow use of an accessory parcel for parking pending issue of a variance from the zoning board. And there's a proposal of Kingston Waterfront LLC on the East Strand, which plans on using an accessory parcel for parking. This planning board made the right call and waived the parking requirements for so many other projects throughout the city, such such as Brunette, the Forsyth, Art Bar, and the expansion of Little Italy. And every new business in Uptown Kingston that had a change of use had its parking requirement waived, such as Boydson's, the Frog Bar, now Redwood, Two Ravens, and the Senate Garage. Thanks in part to these waivers in the Uptown area, there's been a revitalization. The downtown area of Kingston is one of the city's business centers. We must champion development, which will in turn inspire the city to find new ways to address parking, which will be a benefit to all the businesses in the Rondo. In conclusion, I encourage this planning board to consider the facts. This location is the right location for the Irish Cultural Center to be built. The size of the building does not exceed the height requirement, and the center will be providing more parking than any other business in the area. Thank you.
Trumper Avenue in Kingston. I've worked with the Irish Cultural Center group on the financial portion from the very beginning, I guess. And I think in every process, there comes a point where you may not have every single last comment that can be made, but you've certainly heard the comments 3, 4, 5, 10 times over. And there comes a point where you have to make a decision. And I think, to my mind, Katie Dwyer tonight perfectly summed up where we are in that process. Addressing the issues that have been raised over and over again about the location, and nobody can dispute the historical significance of what the Irish contributed to the roundabout. Nobody can really stand here today and talk about the roundabout being an exclusively residential area, because anybody who's looked at the history of it knows that with the D&H Canal and the bluestone and the bricks and the factories, this was always a mixed community. A community that was jammed up against one another, and a community that was dominated certainly by that D&H Canal paymaster's house that sat right on that paymaster's path going up. The Irish Cultural Center fits in there. The parking issue is going to be addressed by the city of Kingston, and I think that's going to happen, but I don't think that should hold up making a decision and moving forward and bringing people in and developing our economy. It's been mentioned here of the events that the Irish community has sponsored over and over again downtown. Parking has always been an issue for the Hooli. I know I myself have parked many blocks away and walked down. But when people want to go someplace, they'll find the parking. Parking lots are needed. A parking garage is needed down there. These things are going to happen, but they're going to happen because the demand is there based on businesses and economic development. The city sees that it's going to happen. I urge you in this process, we've been to court now, the courts have ruled that this is an upright development, it's in the proper zone. I urge you to move ahead and say, you know, enough is enough, the work's been done, let's make this all happen, let's bring our community together, let's celebrate a real success for the economy of downtown and the city of Kingston. Thanks.